Hello children, good morning to you all. Now we are going to start our today's lesson with some exercise based on nouns. One exercise based on nouns. See, in the beginning when I taught you about the nouns, I taught you about four types of nouns. No, in that one is abstract noun. And we are going to know about the adjectives which are used with the abstract nouns. What are adjectives is our first point now. So, our exercise is based on nouns and adjectives today. Understand? Adjectives are the words which we use with the nouns. They are the describing words. We call them describing words. They are the words which are used with nouns. They are used with nouns, children. They describe the nouns. They are used with nouns. And they describe the quality of the nouns. Quantity, quality, color. So many such factors they explain. For example, if you talk about any girl, Suma is a dash girl, Anicha. You have to describe her quality. You can describe her quality. What you use? Suma is a smart girl. You can say Suma is a beautiful girl. You can say Suma is a clever girl. Suma is very weak girl. Understand? Suma is a healthy girl. Like that, so many words you can use to describe Suma. So such words which tell about the special quality of Suma. Speciality of Suma, they are called adjectives. Understand what I mean? The words which tell you about the special quality of the noun, they are called adjectives. Now here we took the example of one sentence, Suma is a dash girl. Here, Suma is a smart girl, Suma is a clever girl, Suma is a healthy girl, Suma is a weak girl, Suma is a tall girl, anything you tell about. So these words were weak, smart, tall, beautiful, healthy, all these words tell us about the quality, special quality of Suma. So such words which tell us the special quality of any noun, they are called adjectives. For example, our house is very big, our house is very small, our house is old, our house is new. Ours is a rented house. In this way, ours is a own house. In this way, you use many words like big, small, large, old, new, rented, own. These words explain you about the type of your house. We live in a beautiful city. Beautiful is the word which describes the city. It is a very well-planned city. Well-planned is our word to describe our city. In this way, whatever words you use to describe, they are, describe the noun, they are called adjectives. But there are few words, nouns, which you cannot see or feel. You feel but you cannot see or touch. Such are called abstract nouns. With them, how can we use the adjectives is our lesson today. Now, for example, in your textbook it is given like this. First one, hard is the adjective used. Main is the adjective used. Dash, work. With work, What adjective is suitable here? He does hard work to get good marks. We must do hard work. So, hard is the right adjective which goes with the sentence here, with the word here, hard. Hard is the word which goes, adjective which goes with the word work. Suitable, two are given. We have to choose the suitable adjective which is, goes with the given noun form. Understand? Hard or what to say? Main. Out of these two, hard is the word which goes very correctly with the word work. Second, deep, heavy. Traffic. What you say? Deep traffic you say? Or heavy traffic you say? Heavy traffic we say. So, heavy traffic is our answer. So, what is the suitable word adjective we needed here? Heavy. Deep is not used with traffic. Third one is good or hard advice. Good or hard advice. Hard advice and Tama? No, it is good advice. She always gives good advice to others. Understand? Fourth one is strong. Also, it is correct. Strong or rough feeling. Strong or rough feeling. Rough feeling we don't know. Feeling we cannot see at all. We cannot touch. We feel it. The feelings can be strong or weak. Not rough. Rough things if you touch they will be rough. Understand? Strong feeling. The word which correctly goes with feeling is strong. Fifth one. Strong or deep trouble. Strong or deep trouble. Troubles will be deep. Seriousness here. Deep until low to kaadu ikkada. Here, seriousness of the trouble, it is deep. Next comes main, heavy. Main or heavy. Idea, with idea. Heavy idea have you ever seen? No. Main idea. Main idea behind my teaching is to make you understand. Heavy idea behind my teaching is make you understand is wrong. Heavy idea always goes wrong. Main is the right word you have to get. So in this way, we have to use the right adjective with the right noun. And we have to use the correct adjective which suits the given noun. So here, between hard and main, hard suits with work, hard work. Deep and heavy, heavy goes very correctly with the traffic. Good and hard, good goes very correctly with the advice, good advice. Strong or rough, strong feeling is the right one. Strong or deep, again deep trouble is the right one. Main or heavy, main idea. So, hard work, heavy traffic, good advice, strong feeling, deep trouble, main idea. These are the pairs of adjectives and nouns. And now, in our under that your textbook, under that in your textbook, exercises are given, children. Six pairs of adjectives and nouns are given here. You have to use those six pairs of adjectives and nouns in the given sentences. That is the work you have to do. Now you knew how to use them. Now correctly you must use them. Heading will be, you don't need to hear your textbook heading given like this. Now work with a partner and complete these sentences with the answer from exercise A. No. Now work with a partner you should not use, because you are not in the class. You cannot have any partners. You are at home. You have to write on your own in your notebook. So take the heading. Complete these sentences with the answers from exercise A. Complete these sentences with the answers from exercise A. You have to strike off. Now work with the partner you don't use. Exercise A. This is your heading. First one is, have you read this paragraph? Yes, but I don't remember the details, just the main idea. Understand? How it is taken? Have you read this paragraph? I am writing short form paragraph. Conversation it is. Yes. Answer. He says yes. I don't remember the details. Don't remember the details. Just dash. Main idea. It is given in your textbook. As it is, I am showing you. Main idea. You have got, no? Main idea, the heavy idea, we already did that work. Okay, there's a second one. What did the coach tell you before the match? Before the match. Your answer is, he gave us some good advice. Good advice. He gave us some good advice. Third one is, why did you come late to school? Why did you come late to school? There was a dash on the road. Heavy traffic on the road. What will be on the road? Traffic. Heavy traffic we can use. Heavy traffic on the road. So, first three. Have you read this paragraph? Yes, I don't remember the details. Just main idea. You have this page. I am going to give you. Don't worry. What did the coach tell you before the match? He gave us some dash. Good advice. Why did you come late to school? There was a dash on the road. Heavy traffic on the road. Heavy traffic on the road. Next, fourth one. Fourth one. Have you finished your homework? Have you finished your homework? Your answer? No, I think I am in dash now. I am in deep trouble. Deep trouble now. Fifth one is, who do you think will become class monitor this year? Class monitor. This year. I have a dash. Strong feeling. It will be Amrita. It will be Amrita. Sixth. Will it be difficult to contest this year? Yes, you will have to put in a lot of dash, hard work. Will it be difficult to to contest this year in lot of that hard work. So in this way you have to complete the exercise. Same thing I am going to give you in typing also, or else I will write in the textbook and show you. Okay, I will write in the textbook and send you the photograph of the textbook. Okay, so here we stop. This is all for today's class. Thank you, children. Jai Hind.